technology. For more updates and details, please do like, share and subscribe.
Hello friends, welcome back with a new tutorial on MS Excel for the beginners. We are Team Inclusive Globe Technology and I am Moindrila Vasu. Today we are going to learn how to hide and unhide the rows and columns of a worksheet through screen reader NVDA and using keyboard only. Let's open an existing workbook, Student Session 2021.
Student Session 2021-Excel, first batch table, name of the student B1.
We are in a worksheet renamed as First Batch, containing the students' registration details and their required marks in the examination. Let's look at the column headers to understand what types of data are in the table.
SL.no, a 1,
contains the serial number of the students.
Name of the student B1. Email ID C1. Contact number D1. Residential address E1.
These details were provided by the students while filling up the registration form. Now see the next header.
Registration number F1.
Students' registration numbers assigned by the institute. Let's see the next column headers having examination details.
Marks obtained in MS Office G1. Marks obtained in Internet H1. Total marks I1. Percentage J1.
Obtained marks in two subjects, they are total and percentage. Now imagine you are a teacher and you are going to upload these results in the Google Classroom assigned for this batch. Since we only want to publish the results, there is no need to publish the personal details. So we are going to hide the columns containing the email IDs, contact numbers, and the residential addresses of the students. To hide multiple columns at a time, we have to select those. So I'm selecting the columns containing email IDs, contact numbers, and residential addresses. That means column C, D, and E.
C1 email ID through E1 residential address selected row 1 column 3. Quick analysis available.
Hide and unhide option is available on the Home tab under Cells Grouping and inside the Format option. Let's see. I am pressing Alt H for the Home tab.
Ribbon tabs tab control expanded. Home tab selected Alt H2 of 9.
Now I am pressing Tab for Format option under Cells Grouping.
Home grouping, clipboard grouping, cut button, cut left, copy, split button, format, paper, office, clipboard, font edit Alt 8, font size edit home grouping, decrease font, bold toggle button, italic toggle, underlines, border split button, fill color split button, font colors, format set alignment, group middle align, top bottom align, orientation, cut align left toggle, center toggle button, align right toggle, decrease indent button, increase indent, wrap text, merge and center, format cell, number format, home grouping, percent style button, comma style, increase decimal button, decrease decimal, format cell, num styles grouping, format as table, cell styles collapsed, cells grouping, delete split button, collapse, delete, format collapse, change the row height or column width, organize sheets, or protect or hide cells, Alt, H, O.
Format option, now I'm pressing Enter.
Cell size grouping, row height, Alt, H, O, H.
Pressing down arrow.
Auto fit row height, Alt, H, O, column width, Alt, H, O, auto fit column width, Alt, H, O, default width, Alt, H, O, visibility grouping, hide and unhide, collapsed, Alt, H, O, U.
Hide and unhide under visibility grouping. I am pressing Enter.
Hide rows left parent, CTRL plus 9 right parent, Alt, H, O, U, R, CTRL plus 9.
We are in the first option, hide rows. Shortcut key is Alt H O U R. Now see the other options by down arrow.
High columns left parent, CTRL plus 0 right parent, Alt H O U C CTRL plus 0.
This is the second option, hide columns. Shortcut key is Alt H O U C.
Hide sheet Alt H O U S.
Third option, hide worksheets. Shortcut key is Alt H O U S. These are the three options to hide rows, columns, and worksheets. Let's see the next option by down arrow.
Unhide rows left parent, CTRL plus shift plus left parent, right parent, Alt, H, O, U, O, CTRL plus shift plus left parent.
Fourth option, anhydrous. Keyboard shortcut is Alt+H+O+U+O.
Anhy columns left parent, Ctrl plus shift plus right parent, Alt+H+O+U+L, Ctrl plus shift plus right parent.
Fifth option, unhide columns, shortcut key is Alt+H+O+U+L.
Unhide sheet, unavailable, unhide sheets, Alt+H+O+U+H.
Sixth option, unhide worksheets, shortcut key is Alt+H+O+U+H. These are the three options to unhide rows, columns and worksheets. Our goal is to hide the selected columns, so I am choosing hide columns option.
Unhide column, unhide rows, unhide, hide sheet, Alt+H+O, hide columns left parent, Ctrl plus 0 right parent, Alt+H+O+U+C, Ctrl plus 0.
We are in the hide columns option and now I am pressing enter.
First match table, C1 email ID through E1 residential address selected, row 1 column 3 email ID crop C1.
Now see the column headers.
SL.no, A1. Name of the student, B1. Registration number, F1. Marks obtained in MS Office, G1. Marks obtained in Internet, H1. Total marks, I1. Percentage, J1. K1.
The three columns, column C, D and E, have become hidden, so the column B and F become adjacent. The same concept is applicable for hiding the row or rows. Suppose the student at serial number 9 was absent in the examination. So while we publishing the results, we may hide that row. To hide a single row, at first we have to place the cell pointer on any cell of that row. So I am placing the cell pointer at serial number 9.
SL.no, 1 a 2, 2 a 3, 3 a 4, 4 a 5, 5 a 6, 6 a 7, 7 a 8, 8 a 9, 9 a 10.
Pressing Alt+H+O+U for the hide and unhide options.
Ribbon tab of cells, you hide rows left parent, Ctrl plus 9 right parent, Alt+H+O+U+R, Ctrl plus 9.
We are in the first option, hide rows. Now I'm pressing enter.
First batch table, 9 a 10, 9 a 10.
See the serial numbers from 8 to 10.
8 and 9, 10 11.
The entire record of the student at serial number 9 is hidden. Now if we copy the entire table and paste it somewhere else, say for example in a Word file, then we will get the table as it is. Let's see. I am pressing Ctrl A to select entire table.
A1 is L.O through J11 selected, row 1 through 11 column 1, quick analysis available.
Pressing Ctrl C to copy.
Copy.
Now I'm opening MS Word.
Start window, search windows, double word, app, press right to switch preview. Pay word, home group, and good afternoon. Microsoft Word document edit multi-line page 1 section 1 blank.
We are in the Word file. Now I'm pressing Ctrl V to paste.
Paste. Table with 10 rows and 7 columns, level 1 row 10, column 1 10.
Let's see the table column headers. Pressing Ctrl Home for first row first column.
Row 1 SL.no.
We are in the first column header, serial number. Now see the next column headers by Ctrl Alt, right arrow.
Column 2 name of the student. Column 3 registration number. Column 4 marks obtained in MS Office. Column 5 marks obtained in Internet. Column 6 total marks. Column 7 percentage. Edge of table.
Now see the serial numbers. I'm pressing Ctrl Home.
Column 1 SL.no.
Pressing Ctrl Alt down arrow.
Row 2 1. Row 3 2. Row 4 3. Row 5 4. Row 6 5. Row 7 6. Row 8 7. Row 9 8. Row 10 10. Edge of table.
See, it has been pasted as it is without hidden columns and row. Now we can upload this document in the Google Classroom to publish the results. Let's back to the Excel.
Student session 2021-Excel first batch table, A1SL.no through J11 selected, row 1 through 11 column 1.
We are in the Excel table. The result is ready to publish in the different file. So now we can unhide the columns in the Excel file to get back the table in original. To unhide the columns between any two columns, we must select a cell from each of these two columns. So I'm selecting two adjacent cells, B1 and F1.
B1 name of the student through F1 registration number selected row 1 column 2. Quick analysis available.
Now I'm pressing Alt-H-O-U for the hide and unhide options.
Ribbon tab O cells hide rows left parent, CTRL plus 9 right parent, Alt-H-O-U, RCTRL plus 9.
We are in the first option. Pressing down arrow for the unhide columns option.
Hide columns, hide G, Alt, H, unhide rows left, unhide columns left parent, CTRL plus shift plus right parent, Alt, H, O, U, L, CTRL plus shift plus right parent.
Unhide column option. Now I'm pressing enter.
First batch table, B1 name of the student through F1 registration number selected row 1 column 2, name of the student B1.
The columns have become visible. Now let's see the column headers.
SL.no, A1, name of the student D1, email ID C1, contact number D1, residential address E1, registration number F1, marks obtained in MS Office G1, marks obtained in Internet H1, total marks I1, percentage J1, K1.
The table is back to its original form. Similarly, we can unhide the row. So I'm selecting two cells, serial number 8 and 10.
8 and 9. A 9, 8 through A11, 10 selected row 9 through 11 column 1. Quick analysis available.
Pressing Alt-H-O-U for the hide and unhide options.
Ribbon tab cells hide rows left parent, CTRL plus 9 right parent, Alt-H-O-U, RCTRL plus 9.
Pressing down arrow and selecting the option unhide rows.
Hide column, hide sheet, alt, unhide rows left parent, CTRL plus shift plus left parent, right parent, alt, H, O, U, O, CTRL plus shift plus left parent.
Pressing enter.
First batch table, A98 through A11, 10 selected row 9 through 11, column 1.
See the serial numbers from 8 to 10.
8 and 9. 9 to 10. 10 to 11.
The entire record of serial number 9 has become visible again. Let us see another requirement of this table. Let us assume the co-certificate of each student will be posted to their residential address via post office. For this, we are going to print the student names and their residential addresses, which will be used on the envelope for mailing purpose. So we are going to hide all the columns except column B and E. Now this is an example of hiding the non-contiguous columns. So we can either hide the adjacent columns at a time, or we can take the help of go to dialog box for selecting the non-contiguous cells. I'm going with the second option. So I'm pressing Ctrl G for go to dialog box.
Go to dialog, go to colon, reference colon, edit alt plus R line 1 blank.
I'm mentioning the cell references here.
A, 1, comma, C, 1, comma, D, 1, comma, F, 1, colon, J, 1.
Where A1, C1 and D1 referring the column header cells, serial number, email ID and contact number respectively. And F1, colon, J1 referring the cell range starting from registration number to percentage. Comma is the separator and colon denotes range. Now I'm pressing enter.
Student session 2021-XL first batch table A1SL.no through A87 selected row 1 column 1.
For hiding the columns, pressing Alt-H-O-U-C.
Ribbon tab cells hide rows hide first batch table A1SL.no through A8 selected row 1 column 1.
See the available columns.
Name of the student B1. Residential address E1. K1.
See, only the names and residential addresses are visible. Similarly, we can hide the non-contiguous rows. Suppose Andy, who is in B2, is out of station. So he will collect his certificate from the institute. And Lee, who is in B10, was absent in the examination. So there is no need to print their records. So I am hiding the records using go to dialog box. Pressing Ctrl G.
Go to dialog, go to colon, reference colon, edit alt plus R selected A1.
Writing the cell references
B2, comma, B1, 0,
where B1 and B10 referring to cells. Now I'm pressing enter.
Student session 2021-XL first batch table B2 Andy through B3 Antonio selected row 2 column 2.
For hiding the rows, pressing Alt H O U R.
Ribbon tail cells on hide row first batch table B2 Andy through B3 Antonio selected row 2 column 2.
I am showing you the adjacent cells of B2.
Name of the student B1. Antonio B3.
See, there is no B2. Now see the adjacent cells of B10.
John B9. Max B11.
See, there is no B10. Now we can print this worksheet. Next, we are going to unhide the hidden rows and columns to get back the table in its original form. I am pressing Ctrl Home for the first cell.
Name of the student B1.
In this table, we have only two columns, B and E.
Name of the student B1. Residential address E1. K1.
Here we have to notice one thing that if we select a cell from each of these two columns and apply the unhide column option, then only the columns that are hidden between these two columns will become visible. That means only the columns C and D are going to be visible. Then what about the columns which are not in this range? Even the selection of cells from B to K will solve this problem partially. It will unhide all the columns between B to K. But what about the column A? It has a very simple solution. Instead of selecting the cell range, we have to select the entire table by Ctrl A. So I'm selecting the entire table.
The 1SL.O through J11 selected row 1 through 11 column 1. Quick analysis available.
To unhide the columns, pressing Alt H O U L.
Ribbon tail cell size B hide rows left first batch table. The 1SL.O through J11 selected row 1 through 11 column 1. Name of the student B1.
Let's see the column headers.
SL.NO, A1. Name of the student B1. Email ID C1. Contact number D1. Residential address E1. Registration number F1. Marks obtained in MS Office G1. Marks obtained in Internet H1. Total marks I1. Percentage J1. K1.
All the columns become visible. Similarly, we can unhide all the hidden rows at a time by selecting the entire table. But before that, let's see the serial number column once.
SL.O, A1, 2A3, 3A4, 4A5, 5A6, 6A7, 7A8, 8A9, 10A11.
The entire record of serial number 1 and 9 are hidden. Now I'm selecting the entire table by Ctrl A.
A1SL.O through J11 selected row 1 through 11 column 1. Quick analysis available.
To unhide the rows, pressing Alt H O U O.
Ribbon O cell size hide row first batch table A1SL.O through J11 selected row 1 through 11 column 1.
See the serial number column again.
SL.O A1, 1A2, 2A3, 3A4, 4A5, 5A6, 6A7, 7A8, 8A9, 9A10, 10A11.
See, now all the rows are visible. These are the possible ways to hide and unhide the rows and columns of a table. Next, we are going to learn about some more shortcut keys related to this topic. These are relatively easier than before, but there is a bug. Let's hide first two records. So I'm selecting serial number 1 and 2.
A2 1 through A3 2 selected row 2 through 3 column 1. Quick analysis available.
Now I'm pressing Ctrl and number 9 of alphanumeric key. Done. But in this case, NVDA does not mention anything. Now see the serial number column.
SL.O, A1, 3A4, 4A5.
See, the entire record of serial number 1 and 2 become hidden. Similarly, to unhide the rows, I'm selecting the adjacent cells A1 and A4.
A1SL.O through A4 3 selected row 1 through 4 column 1. Quick analysis available.
Now I'm pressing Ctrl Shift and number 9 of alphanumeric key. Or we can say Ctrl and left parenthesis. Done. Now see the serial numbers.
SL.O 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4.
See, the entire record of serial number 1 and 2 become visible again. Here we have to remember that only alphanumeric 9 will work. The number 9 of numeric pad won't work. Similarly, let's hide one column. Suppose we are going to hide the column B, name of all the students. So I'm placing the cell pointer on any cell of that column.
Name of the student B1.
To hide the column or columns, we have to press Ctrl and number 0 of alphanumeric key. Done. Now see the column A to C.
SL.go, A1. Email ID C1.
Column B is hidden. Now to unhide the columns, if we follow the same manner, Ctrl Shift and 0, it won't work. And this is the bug of Excel 2019. Let's see, I'm selecting A1 and C1.
A1 SL.go, through C1 email ID selected row 1 column 1, quick analysis available.
Pressing Ctrl Shift 0. Done. See the column A to C.
SL.go, A1, email ID C1.
See, the column B is still hidden. If you have any other version of Excel, then please try it. Before going to end up today's session, let's recall the shortcut keys. To hide single row or multiple rows, Alt+H+OU+R or Ctrl and alphanumeric 9. To unhide single row or multiple rows, Alt+H+OU+O or Ctrl Shift and alphanumeric 9. To hide the single column or multiple columns, Alt+H+OU+C or Ctrl and alphanumeric 0. To unhide the single column or multiple columns, Alt+H+OU+L. So this is all about for today. If you have any query, then email us at info@inclusiveglobe.com. If you feel this tutorial is informative, please share it to your friends. You can also get the previous tutorial links in the description, and we are eagerly waiting for your valued opinion and a like. Thank you.